action. Got a fully loaded tag team championship match coming up with ACDC and Guns of Beer. JJ has some important business to take care of. With me now is Stephen King. And here comes ACDC. Of course, Darin Corbin and Arik Cannon.
Two of the most talented gentlemen in the Midwest today.
There's quite a reaction on these two here in Hollywood.
Absolutely.
By the way, Stephen, great job with you tonight. Thank you.
Well, thank you, man.
Always a good show when you're around. I appreciate the effort.
I have only just begun to whoop ass and destroy people in fully loaded wrestling. It has only just begun.
Ah, this must be what JJ had to go do.
And here they come.
JJ's got certainly an interesting view on things, doesn't he?
Absolutely, and every master manager needs that. He needs to know exactly what his boys are capable of and exactly how to get into the minds of his opponents.
Well,
it's all mind games. Absolutely. JJ is fairly experienced. He knows what he's doing. However, Cannon and Corbin, long-standing champions, every single place they've ever gone, absolutely outstanding. However, Guns and Beer, if you study their online presence, they have also won titles everywhere they have ever been. Unstoppable champions.
You're right, they are a great tag team. Often why they decided to sign up with JJ.
That is the question. That is the question, absolutely. See, many places I would do a lot of terrible things to get victories and to get titles, but here in Fully Loaded, strange bond has become between me and the fans. And unfortunately, Guns and Beer do not feel the same way. They value the titles over everything, and they know that JJ is the way to keep them. They could have the titles on their own talent and merit, but to keep them, they've chosen to have JJ helping them out every step of the way.
Well, it certainly has been effective thus far, and we'll see how effective it tonight.
Absolutely. Surely Cannon and Warden, the tenured veterans that they are, know exactly what JJ is capable of.
Well, Right, and there are no strangers to shenanigans such as JJ's. Now keep in mind, and I'm sure you're well aware of this, you're an intelligent man. If Darin Corbin and Darin Gannon were to win this match, Darin Corbin would have two championship belts in this belt. That's not small pickings.
True sign of a great tag team pair. Matching gear, boots and tights. Both look like cohesive teams, able to understand each other's thoughts, facial expressions, and movements. These guys don't need to talk. They can just know what to do next.
That's true. Great chemistry between both teams.
Absolutely.
Referee Harvey. Going to do diligence, make sure everything's on the up and up. Underway. It'll be interesting to see which direction this goes.
And here we go.
Sizing each other up. Roll with that wrist lock.
So we're working wrist, elbow, and shoulder. Planted between the pectorals.
And reversal of single leg kick.
Pardon me, Duke. What was that on the apron?
This is different than what I've seen before, but I'm sure it's uncomfortable.
Have the right leg pinned, have the left ankle twisted, creating a fulcrum of pain in the ankle, knee, and crotch. Not unlike, figure four leg lock. And what a smooth maneuver there by Cannon.
That was very impressive. Great athleticism from Eric Cannon.
You're not going to find someone more crisp than Cannon. Traveled and tenured veteran for well over 10 years, very likely over 15 if I recall correctly.
Is he biting his knuckles? Is that what you saw?
He was just
obviously referee didn't see it, didn't call on it.
Doing what he does best. Absolutely beautiful magic. And turning now inside out.
The fans, I was going to ask you about that. The fans here tonight are definitely involved.
Every step of the way.
You seem to have them firmly on your side in your match over tonight.
Strangely enough, I do. As much as I would love to talk about the odd alchemy and chemistry between the Mass and Eric Cannon enjoying a beverage.
He loves his PBR.
Don't tell past. What daddy does in daddy's time is daddy's business. Right now, actually.
Great takeover.
What a smooth arm drag that was. Another reason why Eric Cannon is absolutely, absolutely superior to a lot of talents in today's era. Look at him dominating the larger man because of his talents and his skills learned in so many countries. Eric Cannon has traveled the literal world, Europe multiple times, Japan multiple times, Canada multiple times, even Mexico, I believe. Cannon has been there if there is wrestling there.
He's definitely learned quite a bit along the way. Do you think a solid strategy to work the arm, maybe looking for a submission later on?
Absolutely. Cornell is a striker. Why not? Why not take out the biggest gun that a man has? Cornell is a striker, well known. Gott also fairly capable of strikes. Gott more the power man of the two. Gott, however, has been missing out of the last few fully loaded events.
Right.
Fans wonder why. But Cornell has been carrying that load until tonight. Oh, my.
Looks like he's having a rusty go at things now.
Corbin, oddly enough, making friends with the fans for the moment here.
I think he loves the attention, not so much the fans.
He does love the attention, and Cannon draws that attention as well. Perhaps he's just having a good day, taking the night off from his hatred.
Down into a classic duel here.
I have honestly never seen this before.
Nor have I. This is interesting, making 10 paces.
Oh my!
Big drop kick from Darin.
And a hell of a John Woo drop kick and a shotgun cock for Flair.
Why not, I guess. Nice German suplex there.
And a suplex city champ goes up. I was actually intending to suplex Malachi a few more times than I did. I guess Deicide will have to take that.
Another one. Beautiful form of these suplexes.
Absolutely. Dropping Cornell directly on the neck and top of the shoulders, causing stress, strain, and cramps, causing the mind to fog, the eyes to water. This is beautiful. Oh my, and another one.
JJ looks concerned. Hopefully for his team, he's got the wherewithal to stay out of this match. One, two, close to a three count.
Fairly indistinguishable chant goes up. I'm not sure what they're saying.
You rarely encounter a crowd that is so into things as this crowd is tonight.
Absolutely. This is a hot fans, hot crowd.
Big L's in the corner, raking the eyes across the room.
Again, not tactics that they need to use because they have guns like this in their armory. Oh my.
A double foot stomp to the back. You know he felt that.
Absolutely. Cornell jerks on the neck as Gott comes down on the lower back, causing a hell of a lot of traction. Lots of problems in Corbin's spine right now.
You can see on his face, he's feeling it.
It was a straight line, now it's an S. S as in S.
Cannon momentarily ago looking for a tag, not quite reaching in for it.
Absolutely not quite getting there yet. Cannon ready as a man could possibly be.
Big move to the side there. Putting the rib in there.
Absolutely.
Again.
Absolutely. Rattling the rib cage, shaking the floating rib. That can be absolutely excruciating. The one funny thing about a knockout is you don't feel the pain after, at least for moments and moments. Whereas a kick to the ribs can kill you and you're awake the whole time. Oh my, and right on the ribs again.
That could be problematic for a list of moves that Darin Corbin usually uses.
Absolutely. It doesn't look good for the heavyweight champion right now. My goodness.
Not quite three.
And Cornell cutting the ring in half. And Corbin fighting back.
Darin Corbin getting a little cocky there.
Cornell looking a bit distracted, a bit winded. Letting the focus wander. And here comes Corbin.
I think they've lost their mind, Steven.
There seems to be a trade-off of suck it. And unfortunately, Cornell cannot suck his own venom. Sorry, it's a movie reference that no one has seen. And my goodness.
Mean slap.
Oh, my goodness. Absolutely.
One, two. Long two count.
His brain is rattled. His spinal column jarred.
Can't quite see what's happening from here.
It appears to be a laying bear hug. Cornell is going to go for the tag right here.
Working those ribs.
Brilliant. He's taking the entire ring.
Okay, attempted tag on the foot there, and the referee didn't see it, so don't hold tag.
Oh, my. That's just disrespect. Bo got in rare form tonight. He is happy to be back and fully loaded in front of fans he hates for a company he despises. He is just giving these men his best.
Well, he is here to retain the championship belts. And we've seen in the past, he's been amazing.
Absolutely. Bo showing exactly why he is a champion right here, grinding his opponent into the mat, not letting him up, not letting him breathe. But here comes Corbin again.
Single arm takeover.
Huge hip toss, but look again, veteran maneuver. Bo Gott holding the leg, not letting Corbin make the tag. And here comes Cornell.
Great ring awareness. Cornell going after Eric Cannon outside there, holding the bottom of his back.
Absolutely. Wild haymaker to Cannon. And Cannon refreshes himself on the floor, getting some Popeye power. Oh, my.
Look at that arm, look at the ribs. They seem to have a whole side of the body.
Slowly but surely dismantling the champion himself. They could, in fact, be trying to prove that they, as the tag team champions, were more valued and valuable than the champions. It could be a pride maneuver. Oh, my. Corbin fighting two men.
Holding his own so far.
Oh, but
Bo took care of that.
Yup, right up there with a big strike to the face. And a suck it for Cornell.
And a big boot to the face of Eric Corbin.
Absolutely destructive. Rattling the grain.
Well, Cannon trying to rally the fans here.
Cannon being a veteran once more, rallying the fans, getting Corbin's attention.
Again,
bringing
great,
him back from the veil.
Great ring awareness yet again.
Absolutely. You'll see that from them. They will never let an opponent go unless they are both incapacitated. They own their opponents.
Certainly seems that way.
They cut the ring in half like holy and over.
A rear choke here. Bounced up through the pillow there and holding it again.
Take a rear chin lock, driving him into oxygen just for a moment. Oh my.
Going to show great disrespect. It seems to be phasing very well. Smart tag on that field part.
Oh my, what's this? Oh my goodness, Corbin.
Forcing the DDT.
Corbin forcing two team members to give each other moves.
I've got to say, that was pretty impressive.
And the fans are coming up.
Look at an odd maneuver there.
And the big tag.
Big tag, getting back in the action here. Short arm takedown, another short arm takedown. Eric Cannon taking control back of this match. Big splash in the corner. And another on Gott. Another on Cornell. Missing on Gott for the second time. Double clothesline takedown. That man did not forget where he was.
Oh my, the best in the world neck breaker.
One, two, and a close two count.
That clothesline dug into a neck breaking maneuver from Cannon to CM Punk, and now back. Two scoops.
Big double slam there. One, two. Corbin there
in effect,
the time.
Absolutely. In effect, that was two attitude adjustments from John Cena at one time. Absolutely devastating. Cannon digging deep down inside for the will to win. Let's hear your champ go up. These fans responding to their disrespect.
Oh, a big shot from Eric Cannon.
Oh, my.
quite what is planned.
Oh!
Out in the end,
ginger snap. Ginger snap, and the place comes unhinged.
One, two. Looks like he got the ropes. Looks like he got the ropes.
I believe JJ got the ropes.
I must have missed that. I wouldn't put it past him, though.
I wouldn't put it past him either, and neither is Corbin. Look at Corbin's face. Disingenuous, disgusted, ashamed, shocked. And look at Cornell. Eyes on the prize. Going for another German.
Not quite making it.
Corbin trying to Suplex like City. Oh my.
Bannon there to save the day.
Oh.
Beautiful maneuver from ACDC.
Oh
and a big
my.
Kick to the side of the face. One, two. So close.
How
so
did
close.
He kick out?
Where did he find the willpower to get out of that pin?
These men, this team, Guns and Beer, have made a deal with the devil, and they are not going to give up until they leave with the titles, no matter what they have to suffer through. And even these fans who hate them have to respect the suffering they're going through. Oh my!
Oh my, that.
Cannon's infamous right hand.
We've seen it do some serious damage in the past.
Absolutely. My own right hand, I must admit, I stole directly from Cannon.
Big
wait, what is this?
One, two.
Oh my, one. What?
Guns and Beer steal the win with the help of JJ Cash yet again.
Cannon was writhing for his life, and yet his shoulders didn't come off the ground. I have a feeling shenanigans occurred.
I think you're right, Steven. I get the feeling JJ had a lot to do with that win.
We couldn't see from our angle, but I'd bet JJ Cash money that he was hanging on to Arik Cannon's foot.
I think you're right, Steven.
Check the roaming cam for confirmation. See, that's how smart JJ is. He did it off camera, but surely there's another one floating around that caught through.
It is definitely much more difficult, nearly impossible, to go back and reverse that decision without news.
That's disgusting.
Well, there you have it, folks. Still the FLW Tag Team Champions, Guns and Beer, with the help, of course, of JJ Cash.
Questions about what happened in that last match.
What do you have questions about? We won. Everyone's got a lot of questions about what happened. Just off the view of camera.
I don't care.
We won. That's all that matters.
Apparently so.
I told you my team would win. Well, let's now focus on the number one contender match here. Christian Rose versus the King of Throwdown. Have I told you how much I hate Venom for his music?
I can't say it's my favorite song, but you know, it fits what he's looking for. He's looking to do here. It fits his character, I think.
It fits nothing.
Fans like it.
Fans are stupid. Every idiot in here cheering against my team, and you know who won? My team.
A little bit of outside help, yes, that's what happened.
From who?
JJ. Don't feel like that. Everyone just saw what happened.
The ref did. It's all that matters.
There he is, the man.
More like the King of Throw Up. Because he makes me throw up.
That was very original, JJ. Thank you.
Everything I do is original.
Right. Right.
You keep giving me attitude, I'll slap you. I'm all worked up after my match. But let's get down to the analytics of this, the analytics of this match. Venom, Rose. Rose has got the reach advantage. Venom might be stronger, though. This is a hell of a matchup.
It is. It's going to be an interesting, set of styles going down here.
I mean, Venom's got to worry about his knee. When you're talking about a man who's coming off a broken leg, trying to fight now in this match against Christian Rose, who's not coming off. Right, this match is about to start. Here we go.
We're underway, folks. Venom getting the crowd behind him dead again. It seems like that's what you think here, right?
Get these far no more hunts into this.
Of course, where this match, the number one contender, Darin Corbin's full world championship. Heavyweight championship. A lot of
the line. I hate to ask, but who do you think is the favorite in this match?
It's hard to say, but I think it's going to be better.
I'm waiting for Christian Rose. Christian Rose is about to kick Venom in the knee.
I'm broke the leg.
Right for the knee, but he got out of the way.
Venom's smoking coffee.
He's keeping me aware of it. He knows exactly where to go. Rose is a tactician in that ring. Venom is brute strength. It's brains versus brawn.
He's gotten much better. He's thinking more about it.
Again, look where he just went for.
Absolutely.
He's got to be leery, and now he's got to question whether or not he should be in that ring. And a major knee injury like that is not something you just bounce back from.
But he did, and he was here to fight, and he was here to take the number one benefit. And
I have no doubt he wants to. It becomes whether or not. Oh, no.
A big, big right hook for Christian Rose.
What kind of confidence does he have in that knee?
Not to do that, JJ. Not to do that.
It was a vicious knee.
All right, takedown.
Rose came in, planning to go after that leg, and now Venom's.
Nice scoop slam. That looked to take control of this match early on.
Puts on the brakes, because Rose wisely gets to the outside, takes a powder, needs a minute. Absolutely smart.
Counting on the outside again, 20 count. Keep track.
Get him. Get out of there, Rose. Oh.
Venom, not afraid to take it to the corner. Oh, big chops.
Rose had a plan, and now he got punched in the face. Again.
Wow.
I mean,
don't let you say there.
Okay. All right, now we're going. All right. Good I believe job. It. I believe in Venom now. I don't question the knee anymore. Rose is ready to go now. Oh!
Oh, my.
That might have broke his hand.
That
If that hand is broken, the complexion of this match changes 100%. That hand.
Fantastic. Where he was.
Ring awareness.
Knocking the face of Christian Rose off that table.
They are going to, they are going absolutely after each other. The importance of this match can't be stressed enough. It's your shot at the FLW Heavyweight title.
Why is he getting back in the ring? Big right hooks. Christian Rose coming out back in control and taking it back to him.
Back and forth to start this match.
Looking going after the eyes there.
It's fine. It's all right. Referee. You know, if I'm the referee of this match, I'm letting him kind of get away with some stuff because it's a number one contender's match.
I think you're right. As a referee in matches like this, you do let some things slide. There's so much on the line. You can't get too picky like that.
It's for the heavyweight title and the crown jewel of this company. Oh, there it is.
And there's Christian Rose taking advantage of the injury where Venom is recovering from.
Right to that knee. Now it becomes about the knee. He kept with his strategy.
What a big boot to Venom.
I told
you. Knocking it down the middle of the ring.
Rose didn't let the hot start from Venom take him away from
one. Two count.
Too early in this match for that boot. But maybe he's wearing him down. Yep. Now he goes for another pin. He knows that's not going to win the match. But now look what he had to do. He had to kick out. He had to use his legs.
That saps energy. That hurts the knee already injured. Christian Rose again going after that knee. Nasty match is off.
Rose is methodical, he's smart, and he's violent. That's a dangerous combination.
He's focused on that knee again.
This crowd's 100% behind Venom. But let me tell you, that knee's a problem.
How much does Venom have to overcome that knee?
Oh, fire
good shots.
It's effective.
Giving the first one, landing solidly on the second. Snake Eyes.
Rose now got him in the corner.
Looking at one curve over the other.
Caught it.
Favorite the knee.
Rose didn't see him look back.
No, he did not. Big elbow. Saving himself. Big kick back to Rose.
Just back and forth, and I think the reason is these guys want a shot at their so badly. I mean, you're talking about the most important title.
Drop kick to the knee. Christian Rose knows what his wheelhouse is in this match. Exactly what he needs to be.
Exactly. And he knows the pathway to get to Darin Corbin to Venom's knee.
Certainly for yourself. Elbow drop to the knee.
Yes. For the sake of his career, Venom should tap here, because that knee could get permanent damage.
But is it worth it to go after that title?
I don't know, is your career worth it? I mean, it's an important title.
Venom fighting back with big shots, Christian Rose, why is that what's happening?
I mean, this is Venom's first match back. He's having that injury, broken leg. He hasn't been in a ring since that match.
He's got plenty of damage.
Fighting back. I'll never take that away from Venom. He's a hell of a fighter. Rose, though, now working the pace, now doing exactly what he wants to do. My God.
To the face.
You don't see that very often at all. I mean, this is finally.
So I was telling Steve earlier.
I don't care what you told him while I wasn't here.
I was going to say, these fans are rabid.
They are.
The only kind of reactions you can get out of FLW fans. You don't see this kind of reaction anywhere else.
It is a hot crowd. And now he's taking the airway away. You can't, I've said it before, you can't breathe, you can't whistle.
Right, choking off.
Knees hurt, you can't breathe. Venom is in
the air.
He's having a tough time in this match. Absolutely a tough time. That's it.
But he's hanging on.
Trying to feed off.
Trying to feed off
this crowd.
But it works for now. Nice elbow to the midsection.
You know, I'll say it, off the ropes.
Right. Oh, Venom with a beautiful backdrop.
I'll say this. Venom lost a lot of weight, and that helped him recover quickly from the knee injury. And he had the same amount of weight. I don't know if he'd be back soon.
I think you're right, JJ.
I wonder if he came back too soon as is, though. Judging by the way his knee is, I don't know.
Let's do a four count. Elbow come down. Five.
Oh!
Big right hook.
Now they're just beating the hell out of each other. It's about getting a shot.
That's one of those things that we're seeing the referee let slide here. Close fist.
Oh my goodness.
Fish
the knee, the look slows him down. There's a hair slow now because of that knee. Oh, see it?
Oh my. Christian Rose taking him down a level.
Venom's got to know his knee doesn't let him get much separation. He's got to get up in there. He's got to close the gap. He can't be running moves right now.
Quite unfortunately for him. He
gave him too much. Now Venom's letting this crowd get to him. Rose is letting this crowd get to him. It's in the hurts him.
Oh, double foot off. Why is he going off?
Venom again in the corner.
Big swinging right there.
More of an elbow there than the hand, that hurts more.
Certainly bigger than that knee, though.
Again, grabbing that knee. I can't imagine the pain Venom's going
through. Oh, my. What a counter from Venom.
My God. One leg or not, he's going to give it everything he's got in this match. Splash.
Big splash from Venom. One, two. Christian Rose kicks out of the big
You
got
to believe in a normal match, it would be over.
That was vintage Venom. That had a lot more impact back in the day.
You said vintage one more time, I'm going to slap the hell out of you, Cole.
Bring a bit more testy. So let's go off here.
In the corner now, and again, what did I say to you?
Target.
What did I say to you? Anything that's... Pull him over.
And a lion tamer, Christian Rose flies. You know he's doing that.
He sits it down, and it's over.
And he's focusing on the knee.
Again, what did I say to you earlier? Any move that involves Venom running, he's too slow. He can't do it with that knee. Rose is back to a five count. Wisely took advantage of it. I think he said ring the bell.
It's not his fault.
I'm pretty sure he said ring the bell.
Sounds like Christian Rose happy with the
again.
There.
Again, it's just... You gotta wonder when this comes down to the ref's decision on that knee, though. If Venom can't defend himself because his knee doesn't work,
we'll have to wait and see. He's still on his feet.
We've seen one ref decision in FLW with Darin, Corbin beat on Wolfgang Danger's arm. Wolf Danger's arm. And now a slam.
One, two, kick it out. Two.
The full power of that slam, though, you gotta wonder if he could have hit it better if he needed it.
It's again, that knee comes to play.
Now he's
going on his feet.
Again, though, watch. It's a running move. I don't. You said it this whole match. He can't do that running moves. They got some Cobra clutch. Oh! Still got him in it.
Sliding on the Cobra clutch.
This might be it.
Holding the bolt. Christian Rose. Contemplated, should he give up?
That was an incredible counter. Rose was trying to feed into an elbow and he caught him.
He's fighting back.
This match might be over.
And he makes it.
Somehow he makes it.
Venom now. What's it going to take to beat Christian Rose? What's it going to take to beat the King of Throwdown Venom?
Venom getting the crowd behind him. Adding momentum to his already momentum crowd.
Back.
Oh! Foot
to the face.
Right
to the mush.
That word again.
We're making a thing.
Oh! Venom countered with the spear. Christian Rose seemed to have sensed it. Getting Vikings a full attack, but I think it didn't happen.
What the hell are the Vikings doing here?
What the hell are the Vikings doing here? The Viking war party has no business being out here. I think Venom might be in
Let me say something, though. Venom stuck his nose in their business. Venom stuck his nose in their business, and now he's reaping those.
That is true. That is true. I think
it's on him.
Pay for himself.
Into the
chair shot.
Got him up for the ride, the lightning. Got him up for the ride, the lightning.
One, two, three. There
That's
it is.
That's it. What a match.
Winner.
Hit him with the Ride the Lightning. Christian Rose is the number one contender for the FLW Heavyweight Title. Wisely got the hell out of Dodge. You see Rose bail? Rose got the hell out of Dodge. Because he knew, absolutely knew, that the Viking War Party was coming. And they didn't care if Rose was in the ring, that hurt him. These are three sick, sadistic sons of bitches. And I'm not gonna lie. I love him.
They're
gonna kill him.
For the little one to go up
They're
top.
Gonna kill him.
The little Viking.
The little Viking. You gotta wonder.
There
goes Mr. Incredible Scott
Story. Rescue, trying to help their friend, Taggy Parker. Security getting involved.
Here comes security. Security now trying to get involved.
Trying to keep some order.
He just punched the hell out of that security. Jesus Christ!
These guys did not sign up for this. They are.
My God, they are killing each other.
What a beatdown.
Security now getting between them. Scott Story now trying to fight back against the little Viking.
Venom's out. Security's out. Just 2-on-2.
Ring them. Where's the man to ring that bell? I don't know if it'll stop him. The Viking War Party has absolutely cleaned house. They beat the hell out of security, then they beat the hell out of the other three men in the ring. That right there might be your number one contenders for the tag team titles.
Jesus Christ. Back into the ring for what purpose?
He doesn't even look. I'll say what I want here about security. You don't do this to security.
They did not sign up.
There's boundaries. There's boundaries, damn it. That man has
He's
a family.
Been having
you know,
this
I'm a,
trying to
I'm
come
a
back
bad
to
man. You know, I'm not a good guy. But this ain't right. A Viking War Party is too violent.
Ref Gore trying to fight back.
That chair, the equalizer.
They
got the Vikings
out
of the ring,
it seems.
Venom's hurt.
He is. He's in bad shape. Wreckage.
Oh, God.